Alright guys, so this is our last area of the course, that is spreadsheets. Previously, when variances were there in MA1, even then we were expecting like around 10 to 12 questions from spreadsheets. Now the variances and the standard costing have been removed from MA1, so you can expect more number of questions coming from the spreadsheets. And even if you see the revision kits, the updated versions of the revision kit, they have increased the number of questions of spreadsheets comparatively what were there in the previous revision kits. The reason being because this area has now become more important, because more and more questions, more and more number of multiple choice questions can come into your exam. Now this word spreadsheets, what basically we will be doing today, we will be looking towards more practical work. There's nothing you can over here, there's nothing like formula and nothing like costing terminology. We are not going to discuss that today. It's more just the art of computers. We're just going to learn one software, that is your Microsoft Excel, because the best example of a spreadsheet is Microsoft Excel, right? So just giving you an overview, this word spreadsheets, where do you think this word spreadsheets comes from? What do you understand by the term spreadsheets? Normally we use it for the like Excel interchangeably, but what is the word spreadsheet used for? Any idea? You know guys, sorry?
Forecasting and budgeting.
Forecasting and budgeting, definitely, absolutely right. But the word spreadsheets, where does it originate from? Any idea? You know, the word spreadsheets, previously, if you go a good amount of years back, when there were no computers and accountants used to do manual work, what they used to have, one big sheet similar to the Excel sheet that we have right now in computer, right? And they used to spread their workings on that particular one sheet for forecasting or budgeting, as William said. So this particular term has been originated from there as spreadsheets. Now if you just look at the features, so a spreadsheet is a electronic piece of paper divided into rows and column. So you're going to have rows, you're going to have column. Rows are the horizontal axis, columns are the vertical axis. The rows will be in numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, ranging on to the good amount of like 60,000 plus rows you can have in one particular sheet. To tell you exactly, the rows are ranging from 1 to 65,536, right? So rows that you have is ranging from 65,536 in one sheet. Right? And this was about the rows. When you talk about columns, there are 256 columns in one sheet. So how many columns do you have? 256. How many rows do we have?
6,536.
Multiply both of them. What are we getting? 1677716. If you look at the sheet of an Excel, You guys might identify there are small boxes that are there. That box, one box is known as a cell. It means how many cells do we have in one sheet? 16,777,216. Right? So these are the number of cells that you're going to have in one sheet. In one sheet of Excel. Right? So these are very small points from which MCQs can come in your exam. And most widely used, I have already told you, it's Excel. What do we use Excel for? Budgeting, forecasting, variance analysis, making of the financial statements, preparation of the financial statements, preparation of the ledger accounts, right? So these are all the uses of Excel. Now obviously, if you are a beginner on Excel, you cannot do much of the task. So you need to learn quite a few things which you can use in order to produce the required data. Now we can insert text into that, we can insert values into that, and we can insert formulas into that as well. The basic thing that we will be discussing today, the formulas. Alright, now looking further, what do we have? Different skills can be applied. These are the set of skills that we will be discussing today. In the practical form, I will be showing you a spreadsheet how these things are worked on. The basic formulas are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Guys, going back to the, you can say class 2, when according to the basic mathematic rules, when all of the four signs are present in one equation, which one will be applied first? Division will be there, then multiplication, then addition, then subtraction. If power is there as well, what will happen? Any one number has power as well, exponential power. Then power would be solved first, and then the basic rules of division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. If brackets are there, first brackets will be solved, then power, then division, multiplication, addition, and subtraction. So these are the basic mathematics rules. We have some more formulas, like the formulas of sum, formulas of average, formulas of rank, formulas of logical test, that is if else. So these are all the formulas that I will be talking with you guys today. Power is there, how to apply the root, all the things I will be telling you. Relative cell reference and absolute cell reference. Basically, relative cell reference means if you have put C1 multiplied by D1 in any one cell. So when you will be dragging it down, it will be C2 into D2, C3 into D3, C4 into D4. So the movement will also change the relative cell. So that is called the movement of the relative cell. This dollar sign that you see over here, if you place dollar sign before B, B is column or row?
Column.
Right? B is the column. If you place this dollar sign is used to fix the things. If you place dollar B, it means your column would be fixed. If you place $3, it means your row would be fixed. If you place dollar between both of them, it means the cell would be fixed. Everything would be multiplied by that cell only. Because normally when we drag down, the formulas change according to the relativity. If it is C1 into D1, if you drop it down, it will become C2 into D2, C3 into D3. But if you fix the cell, it will become fixed for the use of the calculation. Right, these are the errors in the formula. If you can you divide anything by zero?
No.
So whenever you will be dividing or giving reference of any cell which will be division by zero, it will give you the first error, which is #div/0! Exclamation mark. Value. Can you multiply A with 2? No. Until and unless it is algebra. So we are not talking about algebra over here. So number would be multiplied by number. Okay. So in that case, when you multiply number with number, it will give you a relevant result. So if you have given a reference of a cell in which one cell you have number, the other one you have text, let's say A, B, C, D, whatever. So in that case, you will be getting the second error, which is the error of value. Null. Null reference occur when the formulas are not separated properly. How do you separate? The separator is the comma. The separator in the Excel sheet is comma. So you have to apply proper commas within the formulas. If you don't apply that properly, it will give you error of null. Reference when you give reference error will be there when you give reference of any irrelevant cell which will not be relevant for that formula. And all hash, this error will be there when you have a big value in the cell but the cell is not able to accommodate the whole value, so you will get this error #... right? It means you need to increase the width or the height of the cell in order for this value to be accommodated properly into the cell. Okay, for these charts, when you talk about presenting the information, what different ways are there in which you can present your information? Two different ways are there: graphical presentation and tabular presentation. Tabular means in the form of table, and graphical means in the form of certain graphics. So graphics can be, we can have different charts. Let's suppose pie chart is one of them. The most common chart that is being used is the bar chart, in which you have different bars, right? Have you seen, most of you might have seen the game of cricket. So in that, the overs of any of the particular bowler is shown by the different bars, that how many runs were there in each of the over. So that is shown by different bars. In bar chart itself, again we have different types. In bar chart, you can have simple bar chart. Simple bar chart means for one variable there will be one bar. You can have component bar chart. In one bar there will be two or three components. For example, let's suppose your company have made a sale in the month of January and you have sold three products. That month of January will be showing you the total sale, and that total sale bar will be divided into three areas. The same bar will be divided into three areas. So the top one will be showing sales from product A, then sales from product B, then sales from product C. So when the whole bar is divided into two or three sub bars, that is known as the component bar chart. Then we have multiple bar chart. In the month of January, you are showing two or three bars joined together. That will be known as the component bar chart, right? Then we have, similarly, we have pie chart. How many degrees are there in one circle? 360 degrees. So sometimes you might even get a question that if 80% is represented by any one value in the total pie chart, how much degree is allocated to that? So you should know that there are 360 degrees in a pie chart. Alright, then we have line graph. Again, I'm going to link it to cricket, the game of cricket. If you have ever seen the game of cricket, the scorecard of the cricket game is shown in a form of line, something like this, right? That how the movement of the score of any particular team takes place, and on each of the line there will be the movement within the graph, that in this over the score went up, the score came down. So that is done with the help of the line. So what basically they are doing, they are demonstrating the trend. Whenever we talk about trends, line graph is the best suitable option. Scatter graph usually will be used when you will be comparing two different variables. How? Again, scatter graph would be, it will be a similar kind of a graph, and you would be having certain points over here. Certain points scattered over the graph. This, for example, I'm giving you again the example of a cricket. Then in which of the over wickets fell down. So that will be telling you the relationship between two variables: overs, number of overs bowled, and fall of the wickets. Pie charts, I have already explained you, right? So now I will be showing you certain practical stuff, so you can, yeah. No, percent is 100, but degree is 360. Sometimes they ask you in degrees, then how many degrees are allocated. So you have to work according to 360 degrees. If it is in the form of percentage, then you have to work according to the percentage. Okay, so, okay. Now, this area, if you guys can see the pointer, this area is known as the formula bar. Okay, this area is known as the formula bar, denoted by FX. If you click on this FX, it will show you all the formulas over here. Like sum is there, average is there, hyperlink is there, count is there, max is there, sign is there. All the formulas will be shown to you. This particular one, black box, if you can see this black box over here, this will be showing you that which one is your active cell. So by looking over here, can you see which one is active cell? B3, right? B is the column and 3 is the row. So if I put my cell over here, it will be, the active cell will be B3. This whole box shape structure or the spreadsheet is known as the workbook. It's known as the workbook. This sheet is known as the worksheet. Okay, and this over here, you're gonna have the name of the workbook, which is usually be named as the book 1, normally the start. Is there any need for me to tell you guys how to save the file, how to open a new file? It's very simple. You go over here in the menu. In order to start a new one, you simply click new. If you want to save it, you click save. And if you want to change the name or change the kind, because sometimes even you have the option to save this one as a PDF file, so you click OK, PDF or Excel workbook. I want to save Excel workbook, then some name would be appearing, so you're gonna record that with a particular name. So let's suppose I can say MA1, right? I save it with the MA1, and name would be changed over here as MA1. Okay, now whenever you would be entering the data, okay, one more option you have. I'm gonna tell you certain shortcuts as well, which might be useful to you. Certain shortcuts I will be telling you guys. If you want to save, the shortcut is Control S, right? Let's suppose you are here, you are going down, 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 or let's say you are on Z65565. Okay, so you are here. Can anyone see? The row is 6556 and the column is ZZ. It's too far. Whenever your sheet is started, it is started from A1. Right? If I directly want to go to A1, what will I do? Control home. You directly come to A1. So whatever shortcuts I'm telling, just note them down because these are important, can be examined in the exam. Directly go to the first cell of the sheet. The shortcut is Control home. Okay. Now when I enter the data, I can zoom it in so that everyone can see it easily. Is it fine now? Okay. Now, if I want to write down the formula or anything, enter text, enter number, you can write down either directly highlighting the text or by clicking over here into the formula bar. Now, if you see over here, it is small, ready written over here. I don't know whether it's visible or not. It's small, ready written over here. This area or this bar, this one, if you can see, I'm highlighting with my mouse. This is known as the status bar. This will be showing to you the status. Now, if I'm writing, let's suppose anything, MA1. So you can see two areas are there where the text is appearing. First in the cell itself, and the second one is the formula bar. So if you want to edit, now there's one thing. If you don't have a mouse, let's suppose you're working in a very bad organization, they don't allow you to use mouse, right? So, and you want to edit the cell, how will you edit the cell? You will use F2, because if you directly type anything else, let's suppose ABC, so that MA1 is removed. I don't want this ABC, I want my MA1 to be back, so I will press escape. Again, MA1 has come. Now I want to, instead of writing MA1, I want to write MA2. So instead of writing whole MA2, I will press F2, backspace 2, right? So backspace, when you enter, it will be updated. If you press escape, it will be removed. It will be removed, discarded. Now, this MA2 is over here, right? I want this MA2 to be written until this row 10. What will I do? Write again and again. Okay, if I have to write again and again, then there's no point of using computers. We can do that manually as well. That is where the computer jumps in to save our time. So if you see, there's a small black box over here, small, right? And if I place my pointer on that, the plus sign is coming. So when this plus sign comes in, click your left button of the mouse and then drag and drop. So if you see, the number is increasing. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that is, for example, the Excel is judging itself. So it will be a series of numbers. If it is a possible sequence, it will be judging itself. For example, if I write Sunday over here, so and I drag and drop Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, right? Now instead of this I write 1, 2. Okay, if you only highlight 1, it will not become 2, it will remain 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, right? If you want to write down the series, write 1 over here, write 2 over here, highlight both of them and then drag and drop, it will become 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, this is in the case of numbers. If I want to copy this A1 into B1, what will I do? Two methods are there. I know I'm teaching very basic things to you guys, but that's the part of your course. Right click, copy, right click, paste, right? Now there's one other way as well, without using mouse. Control C, copy, Control V, paste, and then press escape as well, because it is still highlighted to be copied. If I want to remove this from A1, if I want to remove this from A1, cut, I want to cut it. So Control X will be cut, Control V will be paste. Now I'm making a random data. I'm making a random data. That data, for example, I'm making a random marks scored by any of the, let's say, 4 students. So I'll write, okay, fine. Name is there. Marks are there. So I write, all right, fine. Ali, my name, myself, Huzaifa. Then we can have, okay, Taha is there. Then Abdullah is there, right? So I want to write the marks of these students randomly. Marks range from 0 to 100. So if I want to randomly put in the figures, randomly, so I will write down the formula. Your formula will always start with is equals to. If you have put the correct formula but you have not put is equals to before that, it will not be there. Okay, now I write down the formula rand between, yani it means random numbers in between. I open the bracket. If you see over here, it's showing bottom. What will be the lowest score? 0. So I write 0 over here. Then separator. What is the separator? Comma. I write comma over here. Now what it is highlighting? Top. So top 100. And close the bracket. Randomly it appears 18. Now if I drag and drop, Ali has 18 right now. This will also change because it is randomly choosing numbers. Look. Okay. If I do something else, again, if I write anything, okay, again numbers are changed. Numbers are changed. Right? So I delete, numbers are changed. Numbers are changed. If I want to fix these numbers, what will I do? I don't want number to change. I randomly chose the numbers, but now I want these numbers to be fixed so that when I do any other activity in the Excel, they don't change. We have done copy, we have done paste, we have done cut. There's, when you highlight all the cells which you want to be fixed, right click on them and there is one option taste is special. Right? Taste special. Yeah. So, you write taste special. What do you want to paste? The values. If you want to paste the formula, you can also do that with this. If you want to paste the format, like you have particular formats, you have set some color bar or this and that, that can also be done. If you want to copy the comment, how to add the comment, I will also. So we want to paste what? We want to paste the values. So I, okay. Now if instead of formula, what is written over here? 77. It means it has been fixed. If you want to undo this, what is the shortcut to do undo? Control Z. If you see over here, this is, there is a back arrow over here as well on the top, right? This key or this option is undo. And if you can say, it is written over here, Control Z as well. So if I do Control Z again, I am highlighting this. What is written over here in the formula bar? Rand between. It means still the formula is there, numbers are not fixed. So again, what I will do, highlight, copy, paste special values. Okay, so this is about paste special. Now in this thing I can apply some rules as well, that is known as conditional formatting. Conditional formatting means highlight the cells greater than, let's suppose 50, those are greater than 50 are pass, so I will highlight them with green. Okay, greater than 50 are pass. Similarly, I selected again conditional formatting, less than 50 red, they are failed. Okay, so it's highlighted. So you can apply rules as well. Similarly, now I want to remove it, so I will undo it. Undo it again. New rule I want to apply. Data bars I want to attach. The highest one is 91, so that is highlighting the highest one. Okay, I want to apply some color scales. Everything you can do. You want to apply some icon. Okay, the one with the highest marks has the more signals, you can say. Okay, similarly you can do any conditional formatting with the set of data which you have over here. Okay, now the other rule of spreadsheet that we have, yes, formatting. Now this cell that you can see over here has a standard width. If you want to, let's suppose you are having some value something like this, right? Something this value is there, so it will show you like this. So you want this value to be shown properly, so what you can do, you can right click and you can see over here, insert comment. If you want to insert some comment, let's suppose sales figure, you have inserted the comment. Now whenever you will be taking, not clicking, you take it over here, it will show you whatever comment you have written over there. Now if you want to increase the width, you can see over here there is an arrow coming over here. Click it. The actual width, standard width, is 8.43. You increase it, so it will show you now the proper number. Okay, so whenever you have things like this, now you see this value is becoming bigger than the area of the cell. What kind of error is this giving hash 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 hash. It means the area is less for the value to be accommodated. So you increase the width of the cell. Any confusion up till here? Okay. Now what we have, you can also increase the width like this. This option, format cells, it's not given. Okay. Now, if you want to add some borders or something to the cells, that is also very easy. Very easy thing to do. Now, let's suppose two options you have. You can have the borders from here, or you just right click the cell, click on format cells. Here you have tab border. Now you can have any kind of border, simple line, dotted line, more dotted, different kinds of dotted lines, thick line. So you do, okay, like fine, this is the border that I'm gonna have. Or you can easily draw the border yourself as well, something like this. Only on this side you want the border, so you like made the border. So this is how you can make the border, custom border, predefined borders, anything you can do in the Excel. The main thing that we want to discuss are the formulas. Just last thing I want to tell you guys, if you can see over here, this area, what is this known as? Number, right? Number, it's written number over here. Whatever numbers you have, you can present them in a different formats. The first one is number. So it can be shown in decimal places. Yes, it can be. It can have negative number. Yes, it does have the 100 separator. For example, I'm writing, let's suppose 10,000, and I'm writing clicking commas, so it will show by the separator as well. But does it have a currency symbol? No. So the next thing what we can do is the currency symbol. We can apply the currency symbol. You can use the accounting figure as well. It will have the currency symbol, it will be in decimal places, it will have the 1000 separator, and it will have the negative number as well. Now, for example, let's say this is negative 50,000. It is number, you convert it into accounting. It will be shown in brackets. If you convert it into number, it will be shown in without comma things. So you have to apply the comma, things like this. Now let's say I want to do some custom formatting. I will do format cells, number. You can have different symbols over here. Now I want the negative figure to be red. So I selected red over here. Now it is showing red. If I write positive 50,000, it will automatically become black. If I write negative 500, it will automatically become red and in brackets. So this thing is known as formatting. Okay, this thing is known as formatting. You can have different formats for date and time as well. Does any one of you know the shortcut to directly enter today's date into the Excel? Yeah, control and semicolon. It will directly enter the today's did. Two dots. Yeah, today formula as well, you can use that, but that's easy thing. You just control and semicolon. So you enter. Now the date is shown to you in this format. You can change the format of the date. How? If you see, there are two formats for the dates. That is short date and long date. So I click long date. It is showing Thursday, March 27, 2014. It will show you long date. Or you can select, okay, short date, I am fine with that. Or you can alter it as well. Date. Now, if you see over here, different formats are present for date. Just this, only the month and the year, date, month and year. Will be showing 27th March 2014. You don't want day to be there, only this. So it will show you in this particular manner. Now, the simple formulas we have. If I want to add all of these, how will I do it? It's simple. Is equals to sum, bracket open, you select the range B2, B3, B4. So it will be showing from B2 to B5. You close the bracket, will show you 9657. 9657. So this is the formula of what?
Sum.
This is the formula of sum. Just tell me one thing, guys. This formula of sum, we are adding things. Still, we are getting less than 10,000. Why? Because one value is in negative. Right? One value is in negative. Now, if you want to apply the formula of subtraction, it's easy. 10,000. Which cell has 10,000? B2. So I select B2. Minus figure from 500. It will be 10,500. Why 10,500? Because minus, minus, plus. So little bit of common sense is required. Now multiplication is equals to 91 multiplied by 66. So it will give you 6006. Division is equals to 10,000 divided by 66. Give you 151. Now, if you guys can see over here, the points are more. 151.5152. What if you want to round this figure? What if you want to round this figure? So I will write, look, how will I do? The formula will be is equals to round, bracket open, this is the cell, comma, you want it to be rounded to whole numbers, so I will write 0 and close the bracket. 152. So how will you write the formula? The formula will be like this. If any one of you needs to write down the formula, you can write down. This is the formula for rounding. Right? Now, there's one more very good formula which is known as the if else, IFELSE, if else. Let's suppose here we have grades. So I'm writing, let's suppose 86 is the score over here, 91, 66. If you see, When I change 86 over here, every other value over here is changed. Automatically, if you change the value, the formula will pick the updated value and the values will automatically change. Now, if from 500 over here, if I write, let's suppose, automatically the values are changed again. So you don't use the formula, you use a simple addition. Simple addition means if you only want these two to be added, so you will write is equals to B plus C. If you change this one now, it won't affect this. If you change this one now, it won't affect this. But if you change this one, let's say 50, now it is getting affected. Getting my point? Later on, we just move forward right now. Errors we have discussed. Now, there is one more function which is known as sorting. You sort them. So, it's very easy. If you can see over here, there's the option of sorting. You just right click, sort largest to smallest. So, you can say, if you will only select this one, continue with the current selection. Look, it has been sorted, but now the marks have been shuffled because the name have not been selected. So for sorting, you have to do the complete selection. Now when you will sort it, sort from custom sort. So I will, you can say sort the column by marks values largest to smallest. Now if you can see, the names have been shuffled. Now if you do it the other way around, custom sort from smallest to largest, now it will be reversed. Okay, so this is the sorting. One more function is there which is known as the filter. If you click filter over here, small arrows will be over here. If you can see, if I only want to know the marks of, let's say, Abdullah, so it will only show this. If I will select all, it will show all. If I will only select marks of, let's say, 91, it will only show 91. Right, this is how we use the different functions over here in the spreadsheets. I've already told how to add the commands, how to add the comments. Now just a small area I will be touching, which is very easy. Now this area, for let's say we want to have a chart of this one, a graph of this one. So if you see over here, insert, in insert you have charts tab. Under the charts tab you have different charts, column chart. So let's say we have column chart. So you can see we now have one column chart. And you can change the preferences, you can change the design, anything you can do with this. For name, what do you have to do? Right click, select data. Right? For horizontal axis, edit, select the names. Now it is showing. Okay, so if you want to add any of the horizontal or vertical axis, write down, click, select data. This is horizontal, this is vertical. So edit and then select the range. Whenever you select different set of cells from B1 to B10, it is known as range. Okay, so this you can do. Similarly, let's suppose now I want to change chart type. Instead of this, I want to have this. So I'm having this chart. Again, change chart type. Now I don't want to have column chart. I want to have line chart. okay, I will go with the line chart. So we have this Abdullah at some 70s, then Taha, then Huzaifa and Ali. This is, it will be showing you line chart. Similarly, now I want to have pie chart. Now it is showing in pie. If you want to have different colors, okay, it's confusing, everything is red. I want different colors. Colors are different now. Okay, again, you want to change the chart type. This time I want bar charts. It is showing you bar. Okay, again, if you want to change the area chart, this will be showing you area, that how much based on the area is covered by the chart. Okay, now scatter graph, 4 points are there. Same to the line chart, but instead of having line, we are having points over here, scattered over the graph. So this is how you can change the graphs, right? These are the bubble graph. So different options you have in the spreadsheet to present your data in a different manner, right? And the, as far as the theoretical area of the spreadsheets are concerned, I have already given you that in the handout. Apart from that, everything that we have discussed right now is the same thing. There's nothing more to it. It's just the common use of the spreadsheets. Only one thing last is I want to tell you, if you want to change the name of the sheet over here, if you can see the name of the sheet is over here, just double click it and write down the name of the sheet, right? Double click it, write down the name of the sheet. If you want to bring some data into this sheet from the previous sheet, what you will do? Press is equals to, right? Click on this sheet from which you want to bring the data. If you can see, formula has extended. Name of the sheet plus exclamation mark, right? And then you, let's say you want to bring this name. Click enter. Right? Now, again I'll tell you. Press is equals to, select the sheet from which you want to bring the data. You select it, right? The name of the sheet has automatically entered, automatically. Now you want to bring another name. The thing which you want to bring from that particular cell, click it. Now, when you will drag it down, it will automatically bring the other names. And the figures, if you want to bring, is equals to this, this, enter. So if you drag and drop, it will bring the relevant figures again. Now, the thing I was telling you guys about, the cell referencing, absolute referencing and relative reference. Now, let's suppose you have this data in front of you. 5, 6, 4, 6, 4, 5, 7, 9, 1, 3, 4, 5. Now, if I want to multiply, so I can say over here, result. If I want to multiply 5 and 6, what will I do? Is equals to 5 into 6. So it will give me 5, 6 are 30. Now, if I will drag and drop, what will happen? This 5 and 6 is multiplying with each other. Similarly, 4 and 6 will be multiplying, 4 and 5 will be multiplying, 7 and 9 will be multiplying, and this will be giving me the relevant results. These are called relative cells. When I drag and drop, this formula was E4 into F4. If you guys clearly look, the formula is E4 into F4. When I drag it downward, it become E5 into F5. Then E6 into F6. E7 into F7. It means they are changing with the relativity. Now what if I want only these numbers to be multiplied. For example, I am keeping 10 over here. I want these numbers, each of these numbers to multiply with 10 only. So what will I do? I will fix it. And that is known as the absolute cell reference. How will I do that? Which cell is this? E4. So I will write the same formula. I will write over here dollar E dollar 4. It means this time I have fixed the cell. So 10 6 are 60. It means over here the result should also be 60. Over here it will be 50, 90, 30, 50. This is what I am doing. Clear everyone?
Yes, sir.
This is how you do it. And these are the basic uses of the spreadsheets. And I hope when you are, you know that whenever you are saving the file, you have the options to password protect it as well. So you can, by going into the tools, you can use that option by going into saving the file. Okay, so this is the theoretical aspect of the, you can say, spreadsheets. Advantages and disadvantages are very easy, that it is easy to understand, quick, give far better results, used for forecasting and budgeting. So these are the theoretical areas, you can just go through them. Now what we're going to do, we're going to talk about the questions. So take out your revision kit and we're going to talk about the questions of the spreadsheets.